around Midwest as much as I can.
Well, Mike, thank you so much. Just to add one more point. I don't give a lot of speeches. I gave one for the Stansberry Group because it was in Texas, and I could not be away from my kids for, well, I took my kids with me up there. And then I spoke for KC Research, another great group, down in San Antonio to a capacity crowd of high-powered folks. And these people were all so smart, so classy, so cool, and then thanking me that I just felt bad. I don't know how to explain it. It's like I'm not a narcissist. I come off as one sometimes because I'm so aggressive and confident. But I'm always talking about myself, so you know where I'm at. I'm very humble. And it is very humbling to see how many amazing people there are out there. And all I told that crowd was, you better get active, not just at conferences to get more intel, so you're personally successful. You better get involved in information warfare, and most of them have, using the truth against lies, or we're going to lose everything. There's a National Review article out today showing, again, in statistics, upwards of 90% of the illegals vote for socialism and gun control. And conservatives will be like a vestigial claw on a dog's forearm, on a dog's elbow. I mean, it's as useful as you know what's on a boar. And I've never called myself even really a conservative. I'm a libertarian constitutionalist, classical liberal, like George Washington or Thomas Jefferson. In fact, there's the headline, the liberal newcomers. And the subheadline, limit immigration or watch conservative efforts become irrelevant. Yeah. I mean, you've got people with no education who've lived in cardboard boxes getting here from Africa and Central and South America and other areas, and they don't care, folks. The facts are in. They are going to vote for whatever the most hardcore Democratic Party people say, and that's why the Republican leaders are all on board with it, because they're all getting their paycheck from the same big banks. They're all going to retire to an armored country club. They don't care. And I'm not against these poor immigrants. But look, I am against the fact that they are useful idiots. And they're going to take my guns and take my property and force inoculate me. They're going to become the bureaucrats and the enforcers. And as bad as America is, it's not Guatemala. And we're going to be like that now. And it's very sad. Renee in South Carolina, thanks for holding her on the air.
Oh, thanks so much for taking my call, Alex. I wanted to be the voice of the tens of thousands of children that are being raped, tortured, and killed by the so-called global elite. And we need to get Kevin Annett back on because he's doing just incredible work with the international courts in Brussels.
Sure, you're talking about at orphanages in Ireland, Canada, you name it. They dig up just hundreds, in some cases thousands of dead children, Native Americans, Irish children, you name it. And yeah, there is a real cult in government going back thousands of years that likes to prey on children. Most psychopaths aren't just rogue psychos operating on their own and getting caught. They organize into guilds so that they can take their time with the children.
Yeah, and if you read some of the witness testimony, this isn't ancient stuff. This is stuff that's going on. You know, I think the last one that was mentioned was in 2010. And they have hunting parties where they let these children run for their lives and have dogs chase them.
Yep. Well, let me just be clear. I wasn't saying this only happened thousands of years ago. I was saying that every ancient culture, when it declined, sacrificed and tortured children. Whether it was the Aztecs, whether it was the Babylonians, whether it was the Druids, whether it was the different Mediterranean civilizations, this is what ends up happening. And it's part of the decline. You better know that if they're promoting the end of the family and they're promoting, you know, and pushing homosexuality and everything, on the surface, and I'm not even attacking, you know, people out there. It's not my ball of wax. What I'm saying is, historically, we know as historians, even Camille Paglia has written about this, and she's a lesbian, that when you get to this stuff on the surface, down below, it means the other stuff's going on. And yes, ma'am, DynCorp got caught in 2005 running giant child roundup rings. It was even in the Chicago Tribune. It was even in major papers. They had congressional testimony, and no one got in trouble. And the reason they didn't was because it's connected to the government. And that's how they blackmail the judges. It's how they, that's how they took over Penn State. It's how they took over Boys Town. I remember having a former CIA guy on who was also a senator, state senator, John DeCamp, and actually hitting the delay button on him 10 years ago, 15 years ago, when he was saying Penn State's a pedophile ring and Boys Town's a pedophile ring. This is before it came out. Understand, folks, this is before it was in the news. So I hear you, ma'am. God bless you. It is just absolutely hellish what's going on. And the children out there are not getting any relief because people are in denial. Yeah, there it is. Salon reporting on slave trade whistleblowers vindicated. DynCorp. We'll be right back, ladies and gentlemen. I got death threats, by the way, the last time I was really hammering on that story.
This hour brought to you by InfidelBodyArmor.com. When it hits the fan, don't be left without the body armor that will save your life. With prices starting at just $374.99 and ships free. Get yours at InfidelBodyArmor.com. Just won't quit.
Hi, Ted Anderson with Midas Resources. Is it time to convert paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver yet? Get our 10 Reasons book free. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
You heard the discussions all over the radio. You couldn't believe what you were hearing. You trusted them. You felt betrayed. Your emotions began to consume you. Outrage set in. Then, nothing. Days turned to weeks and months. Then, you've forgotten. But they haven't. They're still monitoring your every move. It's coming.
What's coming?
MonitorBlockItPocket.com. Or will you forget?
It's time for a home security quiz. What effective home security device is smaller than a coffee cup, fakes out burglars into thinking someone is home at your house while you're away, plugs into any wall outlet, is recommended by many police departments, and sells for less than $30? Yes, it's fake TV. This year, about one in every 50 U.S. homes will have a break-in, with burglars usually picking the easy target, a dark house that looks like no one is home. Fake TV is a small electronic security device that makes it look like someone is home watching TV by simulating the light from a real TV. Fake TV could be the difference between coming home to a secure house or one that's been ransacked. To get your fake TV for only $29.95 with free shipping, go to faketv.com or call 1-877-5-FAKE-TV. That's 877-532-5388 or go to faketv.com. Fake TV, the burglar deterrent.
Another major health threat, this one in Toledo, Ohio, where everybody in the entire city has been told not to drink the water.
Ohio's governor declaring a state of emergency.
Did you know that the average person uses about 80 to 100 gallons of water at home every single day? If there's a water emergency, will you be prepared?
Panicked residents forming long lines throughout the day.
We're here in a supermarket in Toledo. You can see the shelves empty where water once was.
To stay safe and healthy during a crisis, you must have access to safe, clean water. Water which will not be available at your local grocery store.
There's a mad dash on right now to stock up on supplies.
The ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system is a must-have for every modern, independently minded household. Protect your family's safety during an emergency. Go to InfoWarsStore.com today to purchase your ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system or call 1-888-253-3139.
Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. The third hour is coming up. We'll continue with your phone calls.
Someone to hear you.
Before we go back to them, I just want to mention, coming up for the radio audience and TV audience as well, I'm going to play some of the audio shot inside the man's car with the open window of an unconstitutional, illegal, federally funded, state-instituted checkpoint on the highway. And when the man begins to talk about the Constitution, the whacked out officer rips open the car door and yells like a drill sergeant. Now, that's important because the Associated Press is reporting, quote, snipers, guards, fences, not enough. Secret Service mulls security checkpoints outside the White House on the road. This has been the plan all along. So our border's wide open, but illegal checkpoints to then stop people and demand information from them are okay. And they have private companies in all 50 states hiring cops to make people fill out surveys. And it turns out that's federally funded to just set the precedent that we're North Korea. So we're going to break that down coming up. Some of the other news. Obama's UN ambassador admits fight against ISIS designed to take out Assad in Syria. An amazing video of Samantha Powers being interviewed. That's on Infowars.com. Also, feds swarm a plane, interrogate passengers over travel group logo that resembles ISIS. And now Congress has voted for more war in the Middle East. A Ron Paul article. The Petro Yan cometh. China docks a Navy destroyer in Iran's Strait of Hormuz port. Things are certainly accelerating on that front. But right now, let's go back to your phone calls. Corey in Connecticut, thanks for calling in. Go ahead.
Hi, Alex. How you doing?
Pretty good, brother.
I just want to talk to you about what's going on in high schools now. I got thrown out of school again, second time within a month, for wearing a shirt had a gun on it. And it was just a Johnny Cash, don't take your guns to town shirt. And the first time it happened, it was an AR-15 come and take it shirt. And I had a constitution on me. I read the First Amendment to her, and she just kind of dismissed it like it didn't happen. And I talked to a school resource officer, and he told me that the Constitution, he said I should enjoy it now because it's really not going to be around much longer.
Well, and children are getting kicked out of school for bringing a bubble gun that shoots bubbles. And kids are getting in trouble if they eat a pastry, a Pop-Tart, and it looks like a gun. So soon, I guess if a cloud looks like a gun, they'll have to arrest you. This is all just part of the totalitarianism that they just call regulations. But it's beyond North Korea, but America's a free country, so it can't be happening here. No, it is happening here, and you should document that. You should do a news article about it. But you know, we see 10-year-olds being suspended for making fingers into the shape of a gun. This is all part of the social engineering. But, oh, the kids can go home and play all the murder simulation video games, priming them for drone pilots that they want to. It's all selective. And that's a key part to any totalitarian system. But I also love people that say, oh, the Constitution, I don't want to hear about that in my courtroom. Or, yeah, that won't be around long, buddy. As if they're looking forward to it being gone. As if they're looking forward to having no checks and balances and being slaves. Anything else, Corey?
No, that's about it.
Well, what's your school district in Connecticut?
Manchester.
Well, I would write an article about it. I'd do a YouTube video about it. That's newsworthy. When this stuff goes on, speak out about it. That's the thing to do. Third hour, your phone calls. The illegal checkpoint in Illinois with the police flipping out.
Genesis Communications Radio.
Really, really sad. They want to live in North Korea, I'm telling you.
In the near future.
When you realize how fake it all is, the football, the basketball.
Security alert. This is Homeland Security. Analysis. InfoWars building independent media operations.
We let the worst people get controlled and tell us that we are the ones responsible.
Prime Directive. Discredit Alex Jones.
Jones is the wildly popular conspiracy theorist.
A popular conspiracy theory talk show called InfoWars.
Alex Jones is now in an Austin jail.
These people are assaulting us.
Targeting of patriots engaged.
They are never going to stop. They're never going to deviate from their program until we stop them.
Block free iPhone app at InfoWars.com. Block free podcast and video feed. Imperative. Destroy Prison Planet TV.
You gotta set your eye on the enemy, not worry about what propaganda they put out. Intellectually, it's begun. You can feel it.